We're staying with music because the Korgi single, Everybody's Got to Learn Sometime, became an instant hit when it was released in 1980, propelling the band to success in the UK and Europe.
Well, they're still making music, and as the 45th anniversary of their most well-known song approaches, they've taken the BBC's Imogen Sellers on a tour of their home city of Bath to show her the surprising places it was recorded.
A trip down memory lane to Camden Crescent in Bath. It was here in a top-floor flat that it all started.
1978, I would say. I was with my schoolmate, Ronan Orzabal, who went on to become one half of Tears for Fears, and the two of us recorded here. And people would wonder, why would you record in Camden Crescent? Well, a producer friend of ours called David Lord had a studio in his top-floor flat here. And so we did our first ever recordings here in this top-floor flat of Camden Crescent.
From those days when I believe you actually recorded some of the vocals in the bathroom.
I did.
In this Crescent
I
up
did
here.
Indeed.
And we've come a long way because now, of course, you record in my studio, you know. And
in your bathroom.
You don't have to be in the bathroom anymore.
So, okay, yeah. I have to ask then, you recorded the vocals in the bathroom?
We tried every room in David's flat to get the right sort of vocal sound, the bathroom included. So it may be that If I Had You, our first sort of hit single, could have been recorded actually in the bathroom.
I think it was, yeah.
Before long, the studio moved here to a quiet spot off Walcott Street, and musicians were queuing up to record here.
A lot of very famous names went through these doors in the early 80s. People like Peter Gabriel, Kate Bush, The Stranglers, XTC, Barbara Dixon.
Well, we actually recorded a song called Everybody's Got to Learn Sometime here, which was a big international hit. And it was recorded in there, would you believe?
It's 45 years since Everybody's Got to Learn Sometime was a top 10 hit.
I originally came along with a demo. All I had in mind was a voice, piano, drums and bass, and that was it. But David Lord, being the fantastic musician as well as engineer that he is, he said, no, let's make it something a bit more special, you know. I think I can do something, you know, better with this sort of thing.
As we chatted, they remembered a nearby chapel where they would rehearse. So, for old time's sake, out came the guitar.
We're living in a cartoon world. I'm living with a cartoon girl.
The band are still recording music. Their newest album is called Ununited Nations. What the Korgis are united on, though, is their love of music, still singing and still learning. Sometimes. Everybody's
got... That's incredible.
How did they not look any different?
And they can still sound amazing. They still sound the same.
Yeah.
On the little tour.
On the little tour. I love that. And they just remember things as they go along. Yeah. See, that's the power of music. We've been talking about it. Keep your messages coming in as well about your love songs, because it is the power of music to transform and spot memories and all that sort of stuff. Yeah.